say, hey everyone, Matt here with Anchor Point Church. Just wanted to bring another video and show you how we get our Ableton MIDI cues to ProPresenter. We use it for triggering all of the slides, selecting playlists. We use it to trigger videos, all that stuff. And so I really do hope that this video is helpful to you. And I hope that everything that I go through today will be beneficial to you, but also help make your worship really great. And so I'm going to jump over to the screen and we'll get started. So as you can see here, we actually have our ProPresenter set up here. I have my song in Ableton set up over here. I have Yes, I Will. As I showed you last time, I got my automation here. I don't have anything set in ProPresenter. If you're using my layout for Sunday services, it'll automatically have, if you're using my layout for your songs, it automatically has the automation with these four things in it. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to add Yes, I Will, because I don't have that song in ProPresenter. So I'm actually going to add it from song select, which is one of the things I love about ProPresenter. And of course song select is just that partnership there. So the song is this first one right here. Those are the writers. So I'm going to click on it and hit the little plus icon. And then, I'm going to choose line break, cause I think it's laid out like one line at a time. And so I think that'll work. And then I actually have templates set up in here for my song slides. So I'm just going to choose one that I like. I like this one, and I wanted to add it to the selected playlist. So the playlist that I'm in right now, and I'm gonna hit import. Awesome. I kind of want, okay, is it the right, it's the right lyrics, but the way that it's laid out is not correct. I want to make sure that I'm laying it out in ProPresenter how I have it laid out in Yes, I Will, in the Ableton template. So I'm going to go over to ProPresenter, and I'm going to start laying this out the way that I have it set in Ableton. So if I click this little icon here at the top, it's going to show me my layout. I actually want to choose, I want to add a new arrangement, and I'm going to make it, I'm going to call it full. So this is a full song. And I'm going to choose my layout based on what I have here. And so let's see, what is miscellaneous? Miscellaneous is the tag. Okay, perfect. So what I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna go back to master, and I'm gonna fix this because I wanna get rid of that. And then I'm just gonna add like a blank slide here, just a blank. That way I have a blank slide, and maybe even one more. So let's slide label, actually let's make it a group. Let's call it blank. Slide blank, and then this one I'm going to call copyright so that I have those set in there. I can put blanks wherever I want. First chorus, bridge. Pretty simple song. So let's see how I have it laid out. Got my intro, verse, chorus, interlude, verse, chorus, tag, bridge, bridge. Okay, so let's do this. Let's start this song out. We actually need a blank slide to begin with. Let's go to full here. Because I need to drop in a background for this slide, for this first one. And so blank, got verse one, then I have chorus one, and then let's see, interlude. So let's put another blank after chorus one. And then I've got verse again. So let's put verse after the blank, chorus one. And then we have a tag, so let's do a miscellaneous after chorus one. Okay. And after that tag, goes straight to bridge, which is great. And then we'll put another bridge here because I know there's two bridges. Then we have a chorus directly after that, so we'll go to chorus. And then we have two tags, so I'm going to make sure I have that miscellaneous too. And actually, what I'm going to do is I'm going to rename that miscellaneous too. I'm going to name it tag. Let's see. Let's change the group label to tag. There we go. That way I can see it better for our ProPresenter volunteers, and it's automatically updated in here. So let's look at this. Let's put the copyright at the end. Actually, you know what? I like to have a blank slide before the copyright as well, in case we decide to do something else there. The copyright's not just sitting there the whole time. So blank verse, chorus, and then we have a blank slide for that interlude. verse, straight into chorus. We got the tag there. Straight into bridge. Okay. And then two bridges. Yep. Chorus, tag, tag, ending. Perfect. This is perfectly laid out. So I'm going to move Yes, I Will to second song, because that's going to be the location for it. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to show you how to get the two computers connected. So on the ProPresenter computer, what we need to do is we need to make sure that we have, I'm going to start from scratch here. We need to make sure we open Audio MIDI setup. Now, it may look differently for you because of the operating system you're running. I'm actually running two different operating systems here. For the ProPresenter computer, I'm still running Sierra here. And on my my current computer that I'm editing Ableton on, I am running Catalina. So we're gonna have to maybe just do, the settings will look a little bit differently, but we just need to make sure that we get to network. So on Sierra, network should show up in the MIDI studio. If your window doesn't show up for any reason, you just go to Audio MIDI Setup and then Window and show MIDI Studio and double click on Network. And what you need to do is you need to make sure that you have a session added here. Now, I have two here. I have one that's called Ableton Control that I added, and then I have one that's called 2 Live ProPresenter that allows me to connect this computer and send MIDI triggers to our live stream ProPresenter computer. And so if I don't have somebody that's going to be running that live stream, I actually have all of my slides in ProPresenter set to trigger that live stream. So the pastor's sermon slides, lower third name slides, all that kind of stuff. It's triggering all those MIDI things. And so right now I'm gonna click plus, and under this, it's gonna add a session 1, 2, or 3, however many sessions you have. I usually rename that to whatever it's gonna be controlling. That way I don't get confused if I have more than one. So Ableton Control is the one that I'm connecting to my Ableton computer. And so I'm just gonna leave it there as if we just made it. I named it Ableton Control. And then you need to make sure that your port is separate between the two. Okay, don't make your ports the same. Otherwise you're gonna get MIDI triggers over the same port. It's going to do some weird stuff. Okay. So what you need to do is make sure that you click Ableton Control, make sure that it's enabled, and make sure that you change who may connect to me to anyone, unless you have a directory set up, like a server or something like that set up in a directory, or adding the computer into this. I just choose anyone just for this case here, because it's easier to set up and show you guys. So you don't have to worry about anything with live routings. And so I'm going to leave this open here, and I'm just going to drag this. I'm gonna make it small real quick, and I'm going to show you what it looks like on, this Ableton computer here. So when I click on Audio MIDI Setup, this is what I get. So I'm going to have to go to Window, Show MIDI Studio, and then I have this screen. We see that there's no network. This is where we add the IAC driver earlier for the self cues on the other video that I made. But what we're going to do is we're going to click these little arrows right here. Configure devices, and then open MIDI network setup, and then you get this same screen. Now this is in dark mode, so it's a little bit different looking, but essentially the same stuff. You have to add a session here just like you did before. So you're gonna hit the plus sign. I called it ProPresenter, so I know that this is the computer that I'm controlling. If I was to control the live ProPresenter as well, I would choose that on the actual laptop that we use for Ableton and the drum cage. It actually has both sessions set up here, and it's controlling both computers. And so I just choose ProPresenter here. I'm going to make sure that the port is the same that I had over here. So port 5004. And then you may want to choose your bonjour name, set that up that way whenever it goes to connect, you know, you can, you know, if we call this ProPresenter, that way, you know, it shows up as such. And so I have Pastor Matt here, so that, because this is just my work computer here. So what you do after you get these set up, you don't have to worry about routings. Make sure that you have who may connect to me as anyone. So basically you're setting this up essentially the same on both computers. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over to the ProPresenter computer and I'm going to click Ableton Control, and then I'm going to click on Pastor Matt, and I'm going to click on Connect. And what's going to happen is under Ableton Control, you'll see that the participants, it'll show you right here who is connected. Now, we want to make sure that our latency is really low. I'm connecting these computers over Ethernet. You can connect them over Wi-Fi. Just be careful with the stability of that. But we have done that in the past and it's worked pretty flawlessly. So you can connect it over Wi-Fi if you'd like. Once you have these two set up, you're pretty much ready to go. So what we need to do in Ableton is actually make sure that we have the automation set to this network MIDI setup. So I'm gonna go ahead and close this. Now that I'm connected, go over to Ableton. I'm gonna go to Live Preferences, and I'm gonna go to MIDI here. Now you'll see that I have now in my MIDI ports, Network ProPresenter for input and output. These will not show up until you make that audio MIDI, until you make those audio MIDI changes, those settings in there under network. So input, we want remote to be on. We want to be able to send it. And then output, we want track to be on. Okay, so input for network ProPresenter on, output ProPresenter track on. Okay, once you have these things set up, you need to make sure that under automation for ProPresenter that we have the correct IAC driver selected. Okay, so, and the great thing about this is once you've selected this, as long as you name it the same on the computer you're moving it to, if you're moving it to a computer, you may decide to set all this up on the computer that you're using to run Ableton and ProPresenter. But in my case, you have to make sure that you're setting up as Network ProPresenter, and you need to make sure on the computer that you're transferring to that you change that before you try to get started. The easiest way to you know, combat this and get through it faster is to just name everything the same. So on your laptop or other computer, maybe you're using a Mac Mini or something like that, on your other computer, just name the network session the same. So like I named the session ProPresenter, just name it there and you'll know that it's the right one because it's called network and then the name, whatever you named your session. So now we're set up here to be able to trigger ProPresenter. So what I usually do is I just make this window smaller and I bring in that screen sharing. So let's bring that in over here. And it's really, really small. So let's make it just a little bit bigger. I don't need to see the entire Ableton view for this. And what you can do is you can actually click some of these things over here and get rid of that stuff so you don't have as many things open. Now I have, and I believe these came from Loop Community as well, the ProPresenter MIDI cues. It may have been multi-tracks. I'll put the link down below so you know where these little cues came from. They're pre-made cues. Now you can make them yourself if you don't want to pay for them. It's pretty simple. You just need to make little MIDI cues for each individual thing. The way that ProPresenter is set up currently, now I know the new version of ProPresenter that's out, ProPresenter 7, you don't have to pay for the modules, but you need to make sure that you do have the MIDI module purchased, okay? So once you have the MIDI modules purchased, you'll need to go into your communications, go to MIDI setup, and you'll see like it has the MIDI triggers for each of these things. So if you wanted to create your own MIDI triggers, you could do that, like selecting the playlist is F1. So whenever I go to drag, selecting the playlist, it's gonna have F1 here. And then I'll show you in just a second, but whenever you go to add in, so say for instance, we're using playlist 3 here because it's, 1, 2, 3. It's choosing the playlists that are active right now. So yes, I will is technically the third playlist. So I'm going to choose playlist 3 for my count in here. And you can see that it's showing the notes F♭-1 here. So I'm pretty sure that's what it has set up for ProPresenter. Let's make sure. select playlist item. Sorry, so that's what it's using. Yeah, selecting playlist would be the playlist on the side. It's actually selecting playlist items as F sharp one. So that is correct. You may need to just make sure some of those things are set. Like when we go to trigger slides in here, it'll be G-1. Now it's using F sharp dash one to choose to say select playlist, but it's then using the velocity of the note. So if you increase this right here, it's using the velocity here. 3 is the actual slide number. So in ProPresenter, select playlist item to, I'm going to queue up a playlist item. It still needs to have a velocity to know which playlist item to queue. Okay, same for slides. If it's triggering G-1 as the MIDI queue into ProPresenter, it still needs to know which slide. It knows that it's looking for a slide, but it needs to know which slide. So you would choose like slide 1, slide 2, slide 3, and then your velocity editor right here needs to be, you know, 1, 2, or 3 to coincide with that slide. I hope that makes sense. But these are the notes that it's using for MIDI. You may need to adjust these in your MIDI control for ProPresenter, but usually I think it is set up correctly for the most part. And then, you know, just you need to make sure that that you are connected here in ProPresenter as well before it'll get started. So if you don't have these, you need to make sure that you add these devices. So like if you need to add a MIDI device, make sure that you name it the same. So like, for instance, I named it Ableton Connect, you know, make sure you name it the same. And then it's a core MIDI device, behavior device. And then the source needs to be that Ableton control that we had set up for the session. So under audio MIDI setup, we had Ableton control here. That's the one you're going to choose for Ableton control. So just to make sure that you are, you know, you do have all these things set up. We do not want to choose Ableton control for destinations because we don't want ProPresenter, because ProPresenter can send MIDI cues out as well. We don't want ProPresenter to send MIDI cues out to Ableton, just incoming from Ableton. Okay. So now that we have all that set up, now we can actually get our Ableton to work. So let's do this. Let's see. Let's make sure that we have chosen full. So I have all of my stuff here, and then I'm going to just add a basic background here. Let's see. Let's look for something a little bit nicer. That's kind of cool. All right. So now what I have to do in Ableton here, I'm going to zoom in just a little bit. Playlist 3 is going to choose the playlist item 3, yes I will, but it's not going to trigger any slides. So I'm going to close this up and go to select slide, and I'm going to choose slide 1 right on the intro. So whenever it goes to play through the song, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to let's make sure that this is on. What I usually do is I use the original song as the cues, unless for some reason I'm changing anything. For the most part, I'll use the original song, and I don't need click track. Well, yeah, I don't need click tracks or cues on, but I do need to make sure that automation is turned on and at least select playlist is on. I don't need tempo automator or lighting on. So, and I am going to turn on the metronome in ProPresenter, or I'm sorry, in Ableton, because I want to hear the beats. And so that way I can line things up to where I think it should be. I always want the slides to trigger before we're about to sing the next thing. I want people to know what the lyrics are before we're getting to sing them. And so I want to try to put the put the MIDI cues in there just slightly before we're getting ready to sing that part. So let's go ahead and play through this and make sure that it is triggering slide 1 and make sure that we're not missing anything here. So I'm gonna click this, and let's turn cues on just so
1, 2, 3, 4.
All right, it did not connect. So let's see. Let's make sure that we're still connected here. window, oops, we want the MIDI studio, network, under control. We are connected, okay. Let's see. That's all correct. Did I turn this off somehow? Oh, I turned it off, Ableton. You gotta make sure that you click connected here for Ableton connection here. You gotta make sure each one of these says connected. So now it should work, let's see.
One.
Okay, I just saw it trigger here, so.
One, two, three, four.
There we go. So you may or may not want to put that slide one right on the intro, right as soon as the song gets started. But I like that as soon as the song, like the first note comes in, boom, the transition. Sometimes we'll do like a slower fade from previous background to this background. But for the most of the part, I put slide one to trigger that first background slide right on the first note coming in. So.
One, two, three, four.
And you see it kind of changed there. Okay, so slide one. Now slide two is going to be the verse. So let's do this. All right, so we see here. So I can't put slide two right on where verse one starts because he comes in early. So we need to make sure that we put slide two in there. Slightly early. A lot of times I'll map it out like maybe two beats or maybe a beat ahead. If it's a new song and it's like something real powerful coming on the chorus, I may like delay a little bit because I don't want like the slide to be up there and it's like Jesus has won the victory and like before we even started singing it, because it's like, you know, you want that to be kind of like a new thing, like when you slam it on the chorus, like, you know, Jesus has won the victory or whatever it is. I'm gonna see a victory. It's like, yes. That way it's not like lyrics up there first and you're like, I'm gonna see a victory, and then, you know, you're waiting 5 seconds, it's I'm gonna see a victory. It's kind of, I don't know, you, for at least for newer songs for your congregation, I really like to have it, you know, right before you're about to sing it. Now, if it's a song that we've done a million times, I may put it a little bit earlier, or I may only do the, you know, putting the slide right there when the chorus starts on the first chorus, but then every chorus after that, I'll, you know, bring it in earlier, whatever. So kind of, I don't know, kind of see how it works, listen to the spirit, and figure out kind of how you want these songs to lay out. On these, I do want the lyrics to come in pretty well ahead of the time that we're singing them. So let's see, let's go back to the first slide here on ProPresenter, and I'm going to click back through. And if you click up here at the top, you can start it wherever you want. So I already know how this intro goes, so I'm not going to listen to the entire thing. I'm just going to listen to the partial of the intro and make sure that the slide comes in at a good time. So okay, I like that. So let's do slide three. Let's see if this works. So if I come back here. Okay, I do like how that's laid out. Since we have our transitions in ProPresenter, we have them set to be a lot faster. There's not a whole lot of fade. It comes in quicker, so I think it's fine to have them a little closer to when we start. So let's go back and let's play this again. Okay, so I'm gonna put this one right against this one. Cause I think it's gonna. Okay. I'm just gonna put all those right in a line right there. I think it'll work out well. So let's start from the beginning and kind of listen to this is just the first verse.
two, one, two, three, four.
Okay. Beginning of the song. Okay, they're a little bit behind to me, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to move them over just slightly. Move them all over. Alright, I like that better, having it just like a beat early. Each one of these little blocks right here that you see, each one is basically essentially an upbeat and downbeat. So I like the way that that lays out. It's just enough ahead, but not too far ahead. Once people start basically, you know, singing that last word or the last, you know, two words, depending on how fast the song is, I want it to go ahead and switch. I mean, just like you would if you're reading a book, you know, and you're reading it out loud and you're turning the page, a lot of times you'll turn the page while you're still finishing, you know, out the sentence. That way you're ready to go on the next page. And so I want it to be the same for worship. And so I'm going to try this again to make sure I like it. Pretend like I'm a new person that's never heard this song before. Okay, I'm gonna put chorus just a little bit early too. Well, let's do it a little bit earlier than that. So, oh, let's, all right. So, let me move that back a little bit. All right, I like that. Let's move it back, all back by, let's bring it everything to a head, and we'll just drag them all in here, and let's see if it lays out. Sometimes you can just drag them all in there and see if it lines up, and then kind of adjust them to whatever you feel like is, you know, natural. So let's try this. Okay. So we know those are all behind, so let's move these all back. So. He kind of holds that out a little bit longer. The way that. So I'm going to move that one back. The way that the song select gave us these songs. All right, let's move it back one. Okay. Boom. And then blank. Okay, so I really like that. We have a little issue here. So since we dragged the that video slide at the beginning here, it put that on all the blanks. So let's go over here to Pro Presenter and let's fix that. Let's just edit. Let's go back to master and edit slide. We don't want that background in there. Let's go back. I want it to be just a blank. Here, let's just do this. Delete. Blank. And I'm going to go back to full. I'm just going to drag that before. That's what I meant to do. I dragged it on top of that blank slide. Did not want that. All right. So now I don't have... it's still putting it in the blank playlist though. So let's go back to master. Group label. Call it intro. I'm going to call this group blank. There we go. Intro. Put that blank there. Get rid of this intro. Where's another blank here? Get rid of this intro. Okay, so now I shouldn't be re-triggering that main slide. So now if I go to, let's see, let's do this and play through this again. There we go. That's perfect. All right, so now I'm just gonna go through and I'm gonna make this a little bit smaller. I'm gonna go through and add all those slides where I believe they should be. Once you do that, then you'll have your whole song set up. And when you save the song, collect all and save, you should be absolutely good to go. So I'm gonna do this really quick. I'm gonna speed up the video here and I'll show you what it looks like once it's all finished. So let's go through this real quick and I'll make all these slides. All right, so now I have the whole song set up. You got all your triggers in here. what I normally do for songs, just for the sake of setting them up for the first time, I always have it trigger at the very end, the copyright first. I let it go for, you know, 3-4 seconds, and then I tell it to do the blank slide before the copyright. So if I go through the tag here, and then copyright, and then a lot of times, especially with this one's going to go to the next song already at this point, but I always put a blank slide at the end. Who knows, I may want to do this song as a third song or something like that, and then I want it to trigger, you know, the slides in that manner. I'm actually going to move the blank slide a little closer because I think the copyright's up long enough. Copyright blank. Yeah, that's plenty of time for the copyright. So, all right. Well, we have this whole song set up. You're good to go. Whenever you go to drop this into your Ableton playlist, you'll be all set. Yeah, run with it. I hope that this video was helpful to you. I hope it shows you how you can get connected to computers if you've never done this before. You can do the same thing if you're using this for lighting, for instance. You can have a lighting automation here and set up MIDI triggers for lighting in the same manner on your lighting rig. you know, for instance, we use a computer, a Mac to run our lighting. And so, you know, having the network set up the same way does exactly the same thing. Maybe use something else that allows for MIDI cues that you can set up the same way. We do this even with triggering video in Ableton. So say for instance, you know, we're doing a video behind us while we're doing worship, or say it's an opener video and we're playing along to it. We're providing all the music, but we still need the video to be synced up. If the video has, you know, words or lyrics or voiceover or anything like that, what we'll do is we'll still trigger that video from Ableton in order to line everything up correctly. And so you have to kind of play with it a little bit, because obviously sending a MIDI trigger over the network, there is a little bit of a delay, even though, you know, Audio MIDI setup says there's a zero latency, you're still going to have just a slight bit of delay. So for triggering video, you may have to just like sit there and just play with it a little bit and line it up perfectly. But for the most part, the delay isn't very big. And so, you know, we'll do an opener video where there's, you know, it comes in and it's counting us through the whole time. I'm using the same cues that we use for any of the songs. And so we have Ableton, you know, talking to us and telling us the cues. And then also Ableton might have some of these tracks that I've laid out, and I've laid them out in such a way that, you know, maybe the intro goes long and there's a voiceover or something like that from a video. So there's a lot of cool things you can do with this. Just play around with it, have some fun. And I hope that this, you know, helps to make your worship just absolutely fantastic and engaging. I really do hope and pray that this helps you. Just your congregation will get connected to God and experience Him in maybe a new and a fresh way. You know, a lot of times when we do something new like this, or be able to use cues or tracks, or just simply even just being in timing with each other, like perfectly using cues and click tracks, man, it brings worship to a whole nother level. And I believe that God is honored in it. So I hope this video was helpful to you. If you have any questions or comments, maybe you have a simpler way of doing things, please don't hesitate to let me know. I'll put my information in the description of this video. And as well, I'll put the link to everything that I use here. I'll talk to you guys soon.